The story of this location is of a man who, in a dream, saw himself build a palace. The palace was so beautiful and majestic that the dreamer still remembered its details even after 10 years. To realize such a palace, one typically needs advanced technical knowledge and then hire many laborers to help raise such a structure. But our dreamer was poor, so he couldn't hire anyone. Worst of all, he was uneducated. He knew nothing of architecture or masonry. These obstacles, however, did not stop him from moving towards his dreams. Using just his vision, creative instincts, and an insurmountable will, our dreamer was able to complete a fantastical structure that still stands with us today. This is the story of the Ideal Palace. Today's video takes us back in time and outside the United States. The story takes place in 1864 southern France. It is there that a 29-year-old man named Joseph Ferdinand Chaval had a vision. In a rather odd dream, Chaval saw that he built a palace of magnificent beauty. I use the word odd because Chaval was not a builder. His education has been modest, to say the least. Having been born into a poor family, Chaval left school at the age of 13 to become a baker's apprentice. He later left baking to become a postman, a profession he would practice for the rest of his life. When Chaval retired from the French Postal Service, he wrote an autobiography, which is what I will use as my source for this video. Here's what Chaval wrote in reaction to his own dream. I viewed myself as crazy, insane. I wasn't a mason. I never touched a trowel. Sculpture? I never touched a chisel. As for architecture, I can't say a word on it. I never studied it. I talked to no one about it for fear of being ridiculed, and I felt ridiculous myself. Although the vividness of that dream would stick with him for over a decade, Chaval never attempted defeat. He discarded the dream as that of an insane man's. It's important to note here that this is exactly what most of us would do. When a remarkable challenge presents itself to us, we run away. We bring up plausible excuses. I don't have the money. I don't have the education. I don't have the connections. I don't have the right appearance. What soul on earth has it been scarred by these self-limiting beliefs? Let's go back to our story. It is now 1879, 15 years after Chaval has backed out from his dream. He is now 43 years old. He can no longer be called a young man. One day, as he's walking to do his work, his foot trips over something. When he goes to examine the object, he sees that it is a stone. He found a shape and properties of the stone strangely beautiful. This peculiar stone, for some reason, reminded him of his dream 15 years ago, which he had nearly forgotten. This incident made him develop a habit of collecting stones, which he would then examine at his leisure. One day, as he looked over a stone, he said to himself, "If nature is willing to do the sculpture, I will do the masonry and architecture." He made up his mind to pursue his dreams. Work began that year in 1879. The first obstacle Chaval faced was ridicule. "You're too old. You're not a builder. You don't know architecture." But he kept working. Then Chaval faced logistical difficulties. Finding enough stones for his palace proved difficult. He began making trips searching for stones and then carrying them back several miles. He initially carried the bags on his back. Later he would switch to using a wheelbarrow. Some of his commutes for stones were 3 miles away, 4 miles away, 5 miles away. Some were as far as 9 miles away. Keep in mind that this made a round trip of 18 miles in one day. Not to forget that you're pushing a heavy wheelbarrow on the way back. But he kept working. Chaval bore unforgiving work hours under exposed conditions. He woke up as early as 2 or 3 in the morning to work on his project before doing his regular job as a postman. He then worked late at night under the small light of a lamp. He worked when it was cold. He worked when it was hot. He worked when it was humid. He worked when it rained. There was no pay, no vacation, no one outside cheering, just him building his palace, regardless of weather conditions. But he kept working. I want you to pause right now and think of how many of you would quit by now. You know, that day when it's real cozy inside, but you could hear the cold wind blowing outside. How many of you would still step out to work on your palace? Long commute, hard labor, and ridicule was not the only thing Cheval faced. Death came knocking at the door. Cheval began losing loved ones. He had already lost his wife 6 years ago, but death would not stop there. He wanted more victims. In 1894, death came for Cheval's youngest daughter, Alice. That hit Cheval the hardest. He would go on to write, "Alice bitterly missed," on a family gravestone. In 1921, Cheval's son Cyril passed away. 2 years later, Cheval's second wife would also die, but he kept working. Cheval gathered all the materials to build his palace from his environment. The only thing he purchased was cement and concrete. The entire palace came at a personal cost of 5,000 francs, or about 5,500 American dollars. Like in all other great works, money was the cheapest cost. Cheval had spent 10,000 days, 93,000 hours, a total sum of 33 years, building his palace. But when he was done, the work was majestic. This is a testament to the fact that wealth is in a mine. Plenty of people have passed by the stone Cheval used to make his palace, but to them, they were just rocks. Cheval infused his mind, body, and spirit into these rocks, and arranged them into something magnificent. Before going back to our story, I would like to tackle the elephant in the room. That is, how did Cheval figure out how to build a palace without knowledge of architecture or structural engineering? Material science and load distribution are not obvious principles, you know? Well, I did my research and it seemed like Cheval read books and educated himself, but that still wasn't enough. After doing some thinking, I think I found the answer from a quote by Emerson. "Do the thing and you will have the power." Years after the palace was complete, word had spread and Cheval began receiving recognition. The German artist Max Ernst created a collage titled "The Postman Cheval" in his honor. The young Pablo Picasso also visited the palace and was deeply inspired. After admiring Cheval's work, Picasso created a series of drawings telling the narrative. This work of Picasso is known as the Factor Cheval sketchbook. Later, even though official authorities would pay Cheval his homage, the French Minister of Culture made the palace an official landmark in 1969, and a postage stamp was made after the palace in 1984. Well, as for Cheval himself, having found satisfaction and peace from his palace, he wanted to be buried there. But such burial was illegal in France. He then spent 8 more years building a mausoleum for himself in a Hauterive cemetery. He died a year later at the age of 88 and was indeed buried at the mausoleum he built. Those of you who want to go pay your respects to Cheval can save this location on a Cityscape app. There are many things we could learn from this story. We could learn that it takes time to build a palace. We could see that life sometimes throws formidable trials at us, but we could bear them. But the biggest message I think Cheval wanted to share is that you are not a worm of the earth. There is nobility in you. Cheval was not from a prominent family, nor was he rich or educated. But yet through his work, he lifted his name from the obscure. Cheval is still in our minds today, even after 100 years. He has become timeless, and so can you.